Tonight, Halloween stampede horror in South Korea. At least 151 killed, dozens injured. Melbourne rocked by a night of extreme violence. One man dead, six in hospital, the latest live. Also, the election promise to feed Victorian children free of charge. A new plan to slash the cost of soaring power bills and exclusive access inside the stables of Gay Waterhouse as the Queen of Aussie Racing dreams of Melbourne Cup glory.
Live from Melbourne, 7 News with Blake Johnson starts now.
Good evening. At least 151 people have been killed and dozens injured in a crowd crush in the South Korean capital of Seoul. Authorities say most of the victims were young and out celebrating Halloween. A search is now underway to find if any Australians are caught in the tragedy.
They came to party, about 100,000 jammed in Seoul's restaurant and nightlife district, Itaewon, for Halloween. At 20 past 10, the celebration slipped to panic.
Oh my God, oh my God.
Then alarm. Hundreds who tried to move through an alley too narrow for the crowd, pinned where they stood, then overcome. The human crush locked on itself. It was like a scene from a movie, this man says, like things happening during a war. Emergency workers, eventually 1,700 of them, and bystanders raced to resuscitate victims. They were doing CPR, he says. People were rushing in. It was completely out of control. Scores died on the street, more in ambulances and in hospitals. The incident happened, explains the local fire chief, when a large number of people fell and caused serious casualties. South Korea's President Yoon visited the alley, telling his people, this tragedy and disaster should not have happened. The US president learning of the crowd crush as he campaigned.
South Korea, correct?
Saying later in a statement, we grieve with the people of Korea. Australia's Foreign Affairs Minister sending deepest condolences to the loved ones of those killed. A hallmark for this Seoul district, Halloween had been muted for 2 years by the pandemic. This, its comeback, simply too big. The police, he says, were not prepared. There were way too many people. It was too crowded. Tim Lester, 7 News.
Jennifer Beshwati is in Canberra tonight. Jen, there are concerns Australians are caught up in this tragedy.
Good evening, Blake. There are reports that a young Australian woman is missing and presumed dead, with quotes online from a friend who's trying to find her, but I stress that is yet to be confirmed. The Department of Foreign Affairs is working very closely with Korean authorities to try and identify if Australians have been killed or injured. Now, a local fire chief did confirm that 19 foreigners have died, including people from China, Norway and Iran, and the Seoul district where this tragedy occurred is a popular destination for both locals and tourists. So we expect that number to rise. We should know more by tomorrow. Blake?
Jen, thank you. Melbourne has been rocked by a night of extreme violence, with one man dead and six others taken to hospital. Our reporters have the latest on the investigation. Paul Dowsley, first to you. A wild brawl turned deadly on Bourke Street.
It started here, Blake, it seems, in terms of the violence, in terms of stabbings, and the victim was stabbed here, died later in hospital. The killer tonight still on the run, and homicide detectives are yet to release any details. But what is just into our newsroom, this vision we can show you, is where it may well have started. This is a service station in Dandenong North, about 10 o'clock last night. A Porsche driver and his two passengers are being confronted by at least four offenders, one possibly armed with a pole. The female passenger there runs away in terror. The driver was stabbed and he is tonight in a stable condition in the Alfred Hospital. Police say this may have been the beginning of what they have described as three disgraceful attacks overnight.
A brawl erupts on King Street. A stab victim on the ground is set upon and kicked as fists fly. Another is put in a headlock. A nightclub bouncer runs in, blood smeared on the footpath as fighting breaks out further down. Two young men had been stabbed.
They just all come out of the club in like a stampede, people everywhere. They were running for their lives.
1:25 a.m, Kyle Skipworth was walking back to his hotel after a day at the races and saw the attacker.
He just appeared to be running anywhere there was people until he found the two that he wanted.
He watched as the two men were stabbed, one repeatedly.
About four or five times in the back.
The bleeding victims ran behind Kyle. In a brief standoff, he stared down the attacker with the knife.
He had it down low, ready to stab another person. Sort of tried to talk him out of not stabbing me. Just told him to calm down and he was sizing me up. He was ready to stab me and I guess I was ready to fight him, but I didn't really want to.
4 hours later on Bourke Street, another fight. At least one man with a knife, two stabbed, and for one, it was fatal. Police say this 19-year-old from Broadmeadows with blood splattered on his top and a swollen eye was arrested over the affray, not the homicide.
A number of groups, predominantly young men, coming into the city to cause violence.
Police are still trying to confirm if the stabbings are linked or connected to a carjacking in Dandenong North at 10 last night, where a 53-year-old driver was stabbed repeatedly and his Porsche stolen near a stud road service station. It was found just after 3 in the city.
A number of frankly disgraceful incidents that occurred in our city.
Kyle Skipworth says he tried to help the King Street victims as they lay on the footpath in Flinders Lane.
The guy that got stabbed the most wasn't in a good way. I actually thought he was going to die.
He is tonight in a critical condition.
What do you think of that bloke with the knife?
Oh, absolute piece of shit. I wish I probably, tried to apprehend him. But at the same token, if I did, I wouldn't have been able to give first aid to these two kids.
Paul Dowsley, 7 News.
Now to Sarah Jones at the Alfred Hospital. And Sarah, the victim of a South Bank brawl, is in a critical condition tonight.
That's right, Blake. The 25-year-old man from Springvale is tonight fighting for life after being punched in the face, falling to the ground and hitting his head. It unfolded along Riverside Quay and split out onto the promenade, a footpath just after 12:30 a.m. after two groups of men got into an argument after leaving a nearby bar. Two other men the victim was with were also taken to hospital after receiving facial injuries. Police say there would have been dozens of people who witnessed the terrifying attack.
At the moment, the only description that we do have is a male of African appearance and wearing dark clothing.
And Blake, they are still on the run tonight.
Sarah Jones at the Alfred, thank you. Tactical police have arrested a man who was armed with a loaded gun in Keilor East just after 10 o'clock last night. Police say the 30-year-old was wanted for allegedly threatening a woman with a firearm in Truganina hours earlier. Residents were ordered to stay inside their homes during the standoff.
I didn't know if they'd rammed him or what they'd done, but yeah, big explosion. And then they got him out of the car and they take... All I could hear was the guy going, I'm sorry, I'm really, really sorry, I'm sorry. Then they've got him across the road onto the nature strip.
The man was cornered in a car and taken to hospital under police guard. The opposition is promising free lunches to all Victorian public school students if it wins next month's state election. The $300 million pledge is the latest sweetener aimed at tackling cost of living pressures.
They say there's no such thing as a free lunch.
Who's hungry?
But that will change if Matthew Guy is elected to government next month.
This is a Liberal Nationals plan to provide every school student in Victoria, particularly public school students, with a free, healthy lunch every single day at school.
The opposition's pledged $300 million to trial a free lunch program in government schools for 2 years. Students would have to opt in to receive the meals designed by university nutritionists and made by local cafes using Victorian-grown fruit and veg.
I want them to have a proper healthy lunch to keep them focused, to focus them on learning. And this not just for their kids but also for their parents, for the time and the cost nearly $5,000 a year it's costing the average family to make lunches.
It's the second Liberal election promise targeting the rising cost of living after it committed to slashing public transport fees to just $2 a day. Recent figures show inflation has hit 7.3%, with fresh food prices climbing 8.8% according to Coles.
Cost of living is hitting hard and it's hitting vulnerable families the hardest.
The Andrews government already has a breakfast in schools initiative for select students. It says the opposition's sandwich plan doesn't stack up.
These are the very same people who cancelled a program called Free Fruit Friday. So I think their record speaks for itself.
The Premier spent today in sunshine announcing a $143 million upgrade to the station and delivering news work has begun on airport rail with the removal of transmission towers.
Passengers from Geelong, Bendigo and Ballarat will be able to get directly to the airport via sunshine. They change once and they are into Melbourne Airport. It is really sunshine. It really needs to be seen as both the world's gateway into Melbourne and also our gateway to the world.
Jodie Lee, 7 News.
A new urgent warning has been issued for flood-ravaged Victorian towns. Residents in the affected areas have become very sick with gastro, with concerns about a major outbreak because of a sewage overflow. Authorities say there are already many cases of the illness. The EPA is testing flood water for contamination and residents are advised to only use known safe water. The federal government is considering strict rules and regulations on energy companies to bring down the cost of power bills. It follows budget predictions that electricity and gas prices will surge next year without any indication when they'll come down.
Spending his Sunday at an Italian festival in Sydney.
This one's free.
The Prime Minister is hoping to give greedy energy companies their just desserts.
We'll examine what we can do to take pressure off energy prices.
That's likely to include a mandatory code of conduct, new rules companies must follow or else.
We'll look at the code of conduct and we'll also work with the ACCC.
To perhaps introduce a price cap, meaning companies won't be able to sell gas and coal to Australians at European prices.
We are contemplating the kinds of steps that perhaps governments wouldn't have contemplated a year or two ago, and I think that's important.
From the Oil and Gas Association.
We caution that gas price caps will have a chilling effect on future investment.
It's hoped these new measures will drive down electricity and gas prices and ensure more supply in the market, but it won't happen straight away.
We won't go a day earlier, we won't act a day earlier than until we're sure about the policy settings, and nor will we wait a day longer.
So when will households start to see energy prices come down?
We know that they will moderate in time.
The opposition says that's not good enough.
We need to see them taking action, otherwise Australian households and businesses will continue to struggle.
Another option is offering cash support in the form of rebates for struggling Aussies.
You can go down the path of direct support to households. We don't want to rule out those kinds of options.
But the risk is that could feed into inflation. Jennifer Beshwati, 7 News.
Vic Roads is overhauling its licences to better protect drivers against identity theft. Almost 1 million new documents will be issued to victims of the Optus hack, free of charge. The IDs will have an extra number which allows two-step verification. The changes were already being planned and are being fast-tracked because of the recent cyber attack. Anthony Albanese denies the repatriation of ISIS brides and their children to Sydney and not Melbourne was politically motivated. Speaking exclusively to 7 News, the Prime Minister says it was simply the right thing to do.
The Prime Minister and New South Wales Premier are cooperating.
I've discussed this with Premier Perrottet. Our priority is keeping Australians safe.
But that does not mean they agree.
Robert, you've got to direct those questions to the federal government and to the Victorian government.
The question, inspired by a senior New South Wales government source, is why ISIS brides and their families have been repatriated only to Sydney and not Victoria yet.
No repatriations there because it wouldn't look good ahead of an election. Is that true?
Well, there are no political decisions here. This is a difficult circumstance. The people who were prioritised were on the basis of advice from the national security agencies.
Only those of the lowest risk, after very comprehensive and detailed security assessments, would even be eligible for any such program, and that's what's operated in New South Wales.
Humanitarians say the recent death of Australian teenager Yusuf Zahab inside a Syrian internment camp underscores why families deserve our protection.
All the expert advice points to the fact that it's safer to bring these people home than to leave them there.
But Dominic Perrottet would not publicly support repatriating Australians whose adopted society raped and murdered the families of other Australians.
That decision has been made based on the security advice and the counter-terrorism advice that the federal government has received.
And do you support?
Well, that is the advice that they have received.
This is not a decision that has been made in the best interests of the Australian people.
State and federal governments are providing support for accommodation and ongoing counselling for the returnees, but few details.
For authorities, there is a practical reason to protect the privacy of ISIS brides. Trolling and abuse from an unforgiving public would possibly marginalise them even more and could exacerbate a risk that some perceive is already there. Robert Ovadia, 7 News.
Authorities are racing to find an Australian vet kidnapped in the African nation of Chad. Dr. Jerome Huguenot joined the Sahara Conservation Team a year ago. He was working on the Wadi Fara province on Friday when, according to local media, he was taken. The Australian government is in contact with Chad and French authorities. There are fears the vet is in serious danger. Gay Waterhouse is daring to dream of Melbourne Cup glory, with the Queen of Australian Racing preparing to saddle up 2 races in Tuesday's great race. But the weather gods are not smiling on Flemington, predicting the coldest cup day in a generation.
Cup week with Gay.
Hello.
Racing's first lady is much a champion of the people as the turf, opening the doors at her Flemington stables for owners and connections just 2 days out from the biggest race of the year.
Well, I've been where? Where have I been, man?
Gay giving an up-close look at one of her 2 Melbourne Cup runners.
Come on, Winona, have to come.
Knight's Order, picture perfect, as Waterhouse aims for her 2nd cup win and first since 2013.
Come and have a look. See how high he is. He's a really seriously big horse. You look at the tapples in his ear. He's ready to rock and roll. I've got a very good feel about him.
A phantom call of the cup had Gay off and running. And, unsurprisingly, a winner. While the sun was shining today, this year's cup shapes as the coldest in 27 years.
It's going to be raining, I think, 14 degrees on Tuesday. Do you have any fashion tips for the ladies heading to cup day?
Wear a raincoat and badlon underwear.
After Tuesday's cup, Gay faces a royal challenge, set to train a horse formerly owned by the late Queen Elizabeth II. Just Fine was passed down to King Charles, who opted to sell it. Ownership platform My Racehorse is giving punters a chance to own a share for just $250.
I was lucky enough to be able to train for Her Majesty. She always wanted to hear about her horses. She loved her horses. She also knew about her horses, and she could talk to you about them and ask you questions.
Did you have a direct line to Her Majesty?
I didn't have the direct line, no. You go through the palace, which is correct.
Proof Australia's racing queen still rules the sport of kings. Andrew McCormack.
Lovely to meet you. Yes, good on you.
See you guys.
7 News.
Nice work, Mac. And now we need to find the cup winner. Abby Jelmy, all signs point to a UK raider.
How good is Gay, though? She's absolutely brilliant. But, Blake, the overseas horses look to have a firm grip on the cup. More to come. Also, why there's welcome relief for the Aussies ahead of a crucial World Cup clash. It was far from paradise on the streets of the Gold Coast for the supercars. The AFL boss drops in to see the Roos and Tigers fight it out for a spot in the top 4. And Liverpool's miserable season takes another turn for the worse. It has been an action-packed Sunday of sport. We've got more to come.
See you soon, Abby. Thank you. A fallen tree has had devastating consequences northeast of Melbourne. We're live with the details next in 7 News. Also, the new push for Australia to become a republic. NASA pulls the pin on its vintage headquarters with a bang. We meet the cheeky Melbourne toddler rescued from inside a toy claw machine. And later, a piece of Captain Cook history goes under the hammer.
7 News, brought to you by Queensland. Yep, they grow up that quickly. Time to seize the days like this in Queensland.
It's
Australian Idol is coming to Channel 7 in 2023.
The smash hit show Idol is coming back.
Kyle Sandilands has announced he'll be returning.
He's looking for the next Australian Idol.
King Kyle Sandilands.
Oh, my God.
Also featuring on the judges' panel.
It's Harry Connick Jr.
Megastar Harry Connick Jr.
I love Australian. I cannot wait.
Amy Sharp. I'm really excited.
Megan Trainor.
This is the best gig I've ever had. We're having a blast.
Australian Idol.
Australian Idol returning to Channel 7 and 7 Plus in 2023.
At Coles, we've already locked in the prices on hundreds of products that Aussies love to help keep the cost of living down. And now we're dropping the prices on lots of things and locking them in until January 2023. The prices of your favourites dropped and locked. Not for days or weeks, but months. Thanks, Denise. So keep an eye out for dropped and locked prices across the store at Coles, because prices you can depend on, that's value the Australian way.
As you can see, the BS pandemic continues to spread this racing season. All these punters, they're lining up to get their BS tested.
Sorry, Sarge, but this lot is actually lined up to place a bet.
What? Why?
The easiest way to protect yourself from bad BS is to get on the Sportsbet app.
Oh, that's right. Because for races 1-4 at Flemington and Randwick, here's your bet returns. And if you finish second or third, get up to $50 back in bonus bets with Sportsbet.
Say hello to Lipton Tea Factory, where we let nature do its thing to produce leaves that make Lipton the number one tea brand in the world. Lipton Quality Black. Every sip's delish.
Inhaling the toxic smoke from raw tobacco would be extremely painful.
Smoking is only bearable because tobacco companies mix in masking agents. But no matter what they do to it, you're still inhaling the same toxic poisons. It's the con that kills.
Can you do that again?
Kia, movement that inspires.
To help keep the cost of living down, Coles has dropped and locked prices on products Aussies love, like Coles Beef Scotch Fillet Thinly Sliced, Master Food Squeezy Sauce 500ml and Pepsi 1.25 litre. Prices you can depend on. That's value the Australian way.
A fallen tree has left a driver critically injured northeast of Melbourne. Emma O'Sullivan is at the Alfred Hospital with the latest on his condition. Emma, he suffered shocking head injuries.
Blake, the man was flown here in a critical condition after he crashed into a tree that was blocking the St Andrews Kangaroo Ground Road in Panton Hill. That's northeast of Melbourne. Police say this happened shortly before 2 this morning. The tree that came down was huge, blocking 2 lanes of traffic. The SES and the CFA both attended as well to help clear the scene. The man is aged in his 50s. He was the only person in the car. And the SES is further warning all Victorians more severe weather is on the way starting tonight over the next couple of days. They're urging drivers in particular to take care, especially if they're travelling to areas they're not familiar with.
The real concern that we've got is for trees coming down. So whether that's trees down on road or in public spaces as well could be a real concern, given that the ground is so wet at the moment after all the rain that we've had.
And the man from last night's crash remains here in a critical condition. Blake?
Emma, thank you. The Albanese government is taking its first steps towards holding a referendum to break away from the monarchy. A national consultation tour has been announced with the aim of speaking to people who are against electing an Australian head of state. The talks will happen in the first half of next year and the findings will be collated and presented to the government. One of the world's most brutal regimes has issued a terrifying warning, ordering protesters in Iran to stop rioting. The chilling demand came from the head of the country's repressive Revolutionary Guard, saying today is the last day of riots and not to come to the streets anymore. The guards are notorious for using torture and violence against citizens. Iran has been gripped by protests since the death of a 22-year-old Kurdish woman in police custody last month. NASA's former administration headquarters has gone down with a bang as the space agency demolished the old building. the Marshall Space Flight Center in Alabama was brought down in a matter of seconds. It was operating from the 60s until 2020. A new state-of-the-art center will now be built on the site. A toddler has gone to extraordinary lengths to score himself and his friends free toys. The two-year-old crawled into a claw machine in Melbourne's east but couldn't get out.
At first, it was a dream come true for two-year-old Brooklyn.
He was having a ball, like he was smiling, he was laughing, he was picking up the toys and then throwing them down the chute. He didn't want to get out.
For mum Ashley Larson, it was a rude shock.
I was just eating my dinner and I looked up and I thought, I haven't seen him for a couple of minutes. I'm sure he's probably just in the slide, but another minute went by, didn't see him come out, so I thought I'd better go check on him.
The pub manager called the fire brigade, but Ashley's partner saved the day before help arrived, reaching inside to break the perspex when Brooklyn started crying.
It was actually pretty hard to get him out because as he was chucking the toys down the chute, it was kind of blocking it, like clogging it up.
To finally coax her toddler out, Ashley came up with a white lie.
I thought, what's going to get him down? His favourite person, his nanny. And so I said, Nanny's here, come and see Nanny. And so straight away he saw Nanny. And so he just turned around backwards and he just slid on out.
After his adventure, Brooklyn didn't leave empty-handed, taking home two toys for his troubles.
It's not unlike him to do something like this because his nickname is Dennis the Menace for a reason.
Emma O'Sullivan, 7 News.
A Melbourne construction company is thinking outside the box, building makeshift hospital wards to help the state's health crisis. Also ahead, a fire emergency on the Monash, the gun-wielding politician who took the law into her own hands, and the Victorian women making waves with the NYPD.
Be there for the celebration of a lifetime.
Rebecca Gibney, this is your life.
Thank you so much.
A night of emotional reunions with her biggest co-stars.
I think we may be the only couple that have both made out with you on film.
And the most important people in her life.
Very proud of the woman you are.
How she nearly gave up her most iconic role.
I just couldn't verbalise what was wrong.
And some really big surprises.
This is your friend, Jacinda Ardern.
Oh, my God!
This is Your Life with Rebecca Gibney, next Monday on 7 and 7 Plus.
So you really needed a Hemi V8, did you?
Get in.
Enough said.
With the world's most powerful pickup joining the range, Ram eats everything else for breakfast.
Ladbroker, this Melbourne Cup Day with Ladbroke's Odds Boost. Simply head to any race, pick your runner, and tap Odds Boost to watch your odds get even greater.
The Continental Sensations Range. Smell the delicious.
Lobster in the wash? That's pretty good. Almost as good as the incredible 12 gigs of data you'll get from TPG Mobile for just $10 a month for the first 6 months. TPG.
There's almost nothing you won't do, caring for a loved one. Like all the lifting, shifting, showering and sponging. The back rubbing and tear dabbing. So it's funny, the one thing you probably won't do is ask for help. If you look after a loved one, Carer Gateway is a free support service, especially for you. Authorised by the Australian Government, Canberra.
Enjoy a little more with Everyday Rewards. When you shop at Woolworths and Big W, you'll earn rewards credits towards free tableware. For every $20 you spend, earn one rewards credit when you scan your Everyday Rewards card.
True progress takes no shortcuts. But it's not about what path you choose. It's how you choose to get there.
Ladbroker, this Melbourne Cup Day with Ladbroke's Odds Boost. Simply head to any race, pick your runner, and tap Odds Boost to watch your odds get even greater.
A car has burst into flames on the Monash Freeway. The driver noticed smoke billowing from the bonnet and pulled over into the emergency lane. Two city-bound lanes were closed between Narre Warren North and Tinks Roads as fire crews extinguished the blaze. The driver was treated for shock but otherwise wasn't injured. A Melbourne company is revolutionising the construction industry while helping solve the state's health crisis. They're building new hospital wards in just days. With a business model so popular, it's going global.
This Dandenong South factory is like a real-world Legoland.
It's kind of like Lego for adults. It's a lot of fun that we're able to provide a product that is reusable, reconfigurable.
Steel cube frames and ready-made walls and fittings that can rapidly be assembled into strong temporary buildings, providing a near-instant solution for overflowing hospitals.
Within a matter of days, we can get into a lock-up stage and then a matter of weeks complete the fit-out. So what traditionally has taken years, we're now completing in a matter of weeks.
This COVID ward at Monash Health was assembled in less than 24 hours and ready for patients in 3 weeks.
It was very, very rapid. But the end result was also quite, you know, remarkable. It was like it was a permanent structure when you're on the inside as opposed to sort of a portable drop-in environment. It was a very sophisticated finish. It was vital. You know, it really enabled us to separate out clinical streams, which was new through the pandemic.
Other hospitals are following suit, planning rapid expansions of emergency departments.
Since this unit installed a similar product out at our Casey Emergency Department to extend their environment.
Space Cube has been called in for flood relief too, setting up an urgent pop-up Westpac branch in Lismore.
We had the community wanting to go and see their bank manager about how do I rebuild my house.
But the possibilities are endless, from tourism accommodation to hospitality, this one currently set up in the birdcage.
Virtually all materials used to build a space cube are reusable, even staircases. This one's being prepared for the Australian Open. Once they're finished with it, it'll be folded back up, ready for the next one.
They've had so much demand, they're going global, opening sites in London, Paris and Munich.
Melbourne technology and innovation is now going to try and take over the world and change the way the world builds.
Christy Cooper, 7 News.
There are fears of a food shortage across Europe after Russia pulled out of a landmark deal allowing Ukraine to export grain. Vladimir Putin has reportedly finished calling up reservists to fight, with 80,000 conscripts on the front line and more than 200,000 in training.
The physical pain is etched on their faces, lives changed forever. This Kyiv clinic used to treat normal orthopaedic patients, since May, only soldiers.
The first, about the 2 months, it was hard for the psychological level. The injuries after bombs, the most is this one.
Sergei was shot in the leg in Mariupol, arriving in the Russian-occupied city in late March on a helicopter. One of 7 such resupply and reinforcement missions, so dangerous, the president described them as close to suicidal. The father of one documenting the war. After being injured, he was treated in the now infamous Azovstal steelworks.
What was going through your head, Sergei, when you were in that basement?
Under constant shelling and missile strikes, he says, I thought every day was my last. Surrendering in May, he was captured by the Russians, freed weeks later in a prisoner exchange. Most of his comrades from that helicopter were killed. The true number of Ukrainian military casualties is a closely guarded secret. Here, the focus is rehabilitation.
This is our goal. Then the patients would arrive to us, okay, must to go back for the war.
Around 65% are returning to military training or support roles.
If you recover and the war is still ongoing, will you fight again?
Yeah.
I have experience, he says. I should use it. In Kyiv, Ukraine, Sarah Greenolch, 7 News.
A Brazilian congresswoman has pulled out a handgun and stormed into a local bar. Carla Zambelli claims it was in retaliation to an assault she suffered earlier. The New York Police Department is tasked with protecting millions of people in the city that never sleeps, among them some hard-working Aussies fighting crime thousands of kilometres from home.
In the muster room of the 108th precinct, roll call for the afternoon shift.
Officer Coff.
Lieutenant.
Heading out to patrol the streets of Queens, Australian mother Renee Coff. Renee has been with the NYPD for 3 years. She grew up in the small Victorian town of Whittlesea, so the pace is a little different.
75 Charlie, 48 Avenue.
She believes our laid-back nature helps her on the job.
That sort of like, no worries, she'll be right kind of attitude. So I think that helps a lot with situations. So it's not escalating them, it's de-escalating them, which is very important.
Over the Hudson River in the heart of the Big Apple, Detective Fernando Esbandola heads up the department's criminal enterprise. In 2014, he locked up more than 100 gang members.
It was the largest gang indictment in NYPD history.
The NYPD is the largest police department here in the United States with around 36,000 officers. Renee and Fernando are just two of four Australians currently in the force, helping to police a city of more than 8 million people.
I would love to come home and liaison with the Victoria Police or New South Wales Police.
Natasha Squarey, 7 News.
Authorities have intercepted $200 million of meth bound for our shores. Details next in 7 News. Also, the robots helping build for Boeing right here in Melbourne. The frightening cost of Halloween celebrations in Australia and a piece of Captain Cook history up for grabs.
There's one act that breaks all the rules that all Australia will be talking about.
This is the best day of my life.
We have found the winner of Australia's Got Talent!
AGT, next.
Check it out.
Lucky number.
I'll get my camera.
Wasn't it back there?
Look.
No.
160,000! Missed it.
Year after year, K after K, with Toyota Genuine Service, the feeling never fades. Oh, what a feeling. Toyota.
Here's a better bet. For races 1 and 2 at Flemington on Melbourne Cup Day, if your horse runs 2nd, 3rd, 4th or 5th, you'll get double your stake back, up to $100 in bonus cash. That's better. Gamble responsibly.
Enjoy a little more with Everyday Rewards. When you shop at Woolworths and Big W, you'll earn rewards credits towards free tableware. For every $20 you spend, earn one rewards credit when you scan your Everyday Rewards card.
Macca's 30 Days 30 Deals starts this Tuesday. Enjoy a new deal every day of November, like a $2 Big Mac. Only on the My Macca's app. Value means more at Macca's.
We spend our lives surrounded by houses. From your first cubby house to renting a terrace house. The worst house on the best street or that special house to house your fleet. From the how much is this to the let's bid for that.
Sold.
And a lender who says, it's yours now, congrats. In the end, there's one house for you and that's home. Realestate.com.au, Australia's number one address in property.
Having a bet on the cup? Beat the queues with the BlueBet app. It's quick, easy, and secure. Join in less than 2 minutes and get your cup bets on in moments.
Gamble responsibly.
Leave the house with 1% battery. Press buttons to park magically. It loves open space. And it drives just ace. Looks like confidence comes standard with this SUV. The new Corolla. Oh, what a feeling. Toyota.
What kind of guy is Liberal leader Matthew Guy? Victorians outright rejected him at the last election, so the Liberals sacked him. Now he's back, and so are his plans for cuts. He's promised to cut the big build, which will kill thousands of jobs and hurt our economy. As a senior minister, he cut $1 billion from health and waged war on our ambos. And he cut $1 billion from TAFEs and closed 22 campuses. So what kind of guy is Matthew Guy? He's the Liberals' cuts guy. Authorised by C4, Australian Labor Party, Melbourne.
Hong Kong authorities have uncovered a $200 million shipment of methamphetamine en route to Australia. The 1.8 tonnes of liquid meth hidden in cartons of coconut water. It is the city's biggest seizure of the drug. Officials say it was packaged in South America and likely involved a massive international drug trafficking ring. Melbourne aerospace researchers are using robots to help build Boeing aircraft. The groundbreaking technology has extra sensors and safety features, meaning the AI creations can work side by side with workers at the company's Victorian factory.
It's the stuff of science fiction, but working beside a robot is becoming the new norm. His name is Wayne, and he works around the clock at the Boeing Aerostructures factory.
This is groundbreaking, it really is. To actually have cobots working side by side with operators is really the vision for the future.
Unlike a regular robot, he's a cobot. Armed with extra sensors and safety features, it means he can move around people and obstacles in a busy environment with ease. Highly intelligent, all the cobot needs is a quick program at the start of each day before he's put to work.
Green means it's ready to go.
Using a mechanical arm, Wayne is responsible for mundane tasks that previously caused repetitive strain injuries in technicians. His job includes sanding and cleaning the tools to assemble the wings of the 787 aircraft.
He's actually able to sense what sort of equipment is in the room, what the cleaning mechanism is going to be for that tool, and then undertake that task.
Four cobots are already hard at work at the Port Melbourne factory, but there are plans to roll out several more to improve operations around the globe.
It's certainly not the intent to take the place of any workers. We're actually hiring now 300 new individuals for the next 2 years to come in here, so we are growing significantly.
Rochelle Brown, 7 News.
A centuries-old microscope carried on the Endeavour during Captain James Cook's journey to Australia is about to go under the hammer. It was almost forgotten, but is now expected to fetch an eye-watering sum.
A biscuit tin found in an English country house, hiding a treasure.
Blimey, we're handling a proper bit of history here.
A microscope from the 1760s, the former owner, Joseph Banks. He carried it aboard the Endeavour during Captain James Cook's journey up the Australian east coast, using it to examine the exotic sea life the crew found on the Great Barrier Reef.
It's a modest item, but putting this onto the first voyage of discovery with Captain Cook is visceral history. It's everything. This witnessed the first tour of Australia.
Auctioneer Charles Miller helped piece the story together, tracing its ownership back to the famed botanist. But a new custodian awaits.
The auction is on Tuesday, online, with interest already from right around the world. The microscope could be sold to a collector or even a museum.
It's expected to fetch close to $100,000.
Lots of people would love to see it end up in the right national collection. Of course they would. But a private collector who's got judicious taste and pockets might be lucky on the day.
An expensive find in a biscuit tin. In London, Hugh Whitfeld, 7 News.
Final preparations are underway for tomorrow's spooky celebrations, and Aussie retailers are cashing in on the growing Halloween trend. It's estimated Australians will spend $430 million on dress-ups and sweet treats.
It's nice and creepy because I like creepy.
The community have told us that we can never stop doing Halloween because they love coming to our house.
Halloween is becoming a festival for all ages. Stats show 35 to 49-year-olds are the age group most likely to get involved. Abby Jelmy's here with Sport. Abby, the English are here to pinch Aussie Racing's greatest prize.
They certainly are, Blake. They've got the hot favourite for the Cup, and we'll speak to his trainer next. Also, Ben Hayes looking to follow in the footsteps of his family bloodlines. Steve Smith's chances of a recall take a hit as the Aussies welcome back their number one man. The Kangaroos and Tigers put on a thriller in front of the league boss. And supercars chaos on the streets of the Gold Coast.
This entire sorry saga boils down to sex and greed.
How Prince Andrew went from the Queen's favourite to outcast.
He thinks that he can do whatever he wants.
You're an embarrassment, sir.
Those closest to him reveal all.
He couldn't keep his trousers closed.
Dirty money, dirty laundry, and dodgy people.
As Ghislaine Maxwell goes on record.
This really isn't the end of the story.
The premiere event, Prince Andrew Banished, tonight on 7 and 7 Plus.
Mount Everest, it calls us, begging to be conquered. So we climb. No matter how heavy the task, we continue to push. And whilst prying eyes wait to see us fall, we rise. And what we get is pure joy. Why seek the summit? Because we can.
The next gen Ford Everest.
Tab has racing offers on Tab. Bet fixed odds on races 1 to 3 at 3 tracks this Cup Day. And if you run second or third, get a bonus bet back up to $50. For racing on Tab, download the new Tab app.
Gamble responsibly.
At Coles, value means collecting free quality glassware. For every $20 you spend in one transaction, scan your Flybuys card to earn one glassware credit. They're perfect for dinner parties, weekend barbies, and everything in between. Plus, get a bonus glassware credit when you purchase selected products from these participating brands. Free quality glassware. That's value the Australian way at Coles.
Host Plus is a top performing industry super fund run only to benefit our members. An industry fund that puts you first? That's a plus.
At Target, we have gifts for every kind of giver, like the selfless giver and the can't-wait giver.
Mum! It's a kid.
So if you love to give, you'll love Christmas at Target. That's Target.
The 5-year road trip. With an extra 2. Stick to your Toyota service schedule and we'll extend your engine and driveline warranty from 5 years to 7 with unlimited kilometres. Oh, what a feeling. Toyota.
There's a new place to get it all on tap this spring. We've got every race of the Spring Carnival live. The touchdowns and downtowns. The beautiful game. Not that they're not all beautiful. The spinners and winners. This. This too. This. Oh, come on, ref. And inevitably, this. All you need to make it happen is this. For racing and sport on tap, download the new Tab app. You know the score. Stay in control. Gamble responsibly.
This sport report brought to you by Tab. Download the new app today.
Welcome back. Tuesday's Melbourne Cup is shaping to be another chapter in the great sporting rivalry between Australia and England. For the first time since his arrival, UK trainer James Ferguson admits he's feeling the pressure with red-hot favourite Deauville legend.
Werribee has been the home of the International Cup contenders for the past few weeks. Come Tuesday, they'll be gracing the track at Flemington. And it's Deauville legend that is shortened as the only runner at single-figure odds.
They say pressure for tyres, but I'm certainly feeling it a little bit, but that's just nerves to do well.
Trainer James Ferguson primed to snatch Australia's greatest racing prize.
A lot of the international team hoping that we can bring the cup to England. I'd like to say that we're doing quite well at the moment compared to Australia in a few things.
I've been watching them every morning and, we've had a lot of banter and had a lot of fun.
Ed Crisford is also from the UK, a close childhood mate of Ferguson, who'll be putting on the gloves with his runner without a fight.
Dave Eustace lived in the house as well. If someone had said three of us would have had a runner in the Melbourne Cup in 2022, we just would have fallen on the floor laughing.
Ben Hayes has a foot in both the local and international camps. He'll saddle up Irish import Kimura.
He can definitely surprise a lot of people. From what we've seen, he's been working with the cup favourite, and I thought they looked very similar.
It's Jern in front for David Hayes, and Jern wins the Melbourne Cup.
Hayes hoping to follow in the footsteps of his father David's success in 1994 and grandfather Colin in the 80s.
I can't imagine anything better.
It'd be fantastic to be a third generation trainer to be able to win this race.
Tim Hipsley, 7 News.
The Aussies' chances of progressing to the World Cup semi-finals hinge on big wins in their remaining two pool matches. They have received a boost with keeper Matthew Wade back training after testing negative to COVID.
Away from the murk of Melbourne, a spring in the step of the reigning champs.
It's nice to finally get some blue skies and some warm weather. The boys have been freezing over the last couple of days.
The Allen Borderfield practice wickets juiced up, though, from Brisbane's recent wet. Steve Smith wearing one on the finger.
A little challenge on some wickets that have been up for quite a while is always good fun.
Walking the T20 tightrope, the Aussies' net run rate will be the focus.
You never go into a game thinking about things like that. I think that will naturally unfold if the opportunity presents.
Monday's match won't be a pushover. The Irish upset England in a rain-shortened affair already this tournament.
We've seen how damaging Ireland can be if you give them a sniff.
With 10 fours and four sixes, Glenn Phillips again put his name up in lights.
Down the ground, doesn't matter.
The Black Caps batter hammered a 61-ball run ton against a sloppy Sri Lanka.
The roar of delight comes out. Enjoy this moment, Glenn Phillips.
Trent Bolt ran through the Sri Lankan top order. The informed New Zealanders, 65-run winners and well on top of Group 1. Ben Dobson, 7 News.
The T20 World Cup has delivered one of the more bizarre finishes to a cricket match ever seen. Now, Bangladesh thought they'd done enough after Zimbabwe failed to hit the last 5 runs required off the final delivery, only for the third umpire to rule that the wicketkeeper took the ball ahead of the stumps.
The players don't even know this. They're all off the field. And Murray Erasmus has signalled it's a no ball. It's not.
Yeah, needing 4 runs for victory after returning to the middle, Zimbabwe couldn't make the most of their second chance. Richmond has jumped into the top 4 and earned a double chance in the finals after a thrilling draw against North Melbourne. League boss Gillon McLachlan mingled with presidents and CEOs from both clubs. Neither side could be split at the final siren.
Richmond goes into the finals with the double chance.
So the Tigers will face Brisbane next week with Melbourne to host the Crows, while North will square off with Geelong in a sudden death final. Red Bull's Shane van Gisbergen made it a clean sweep on the Gold Coast, but it was far from supercar's paradise as the race was red flagged by a nasty pile-up on the street circuit.
As vast crowds gathered, defence grabbed the last vantage point. It was ideal for a frenetic getaway.
And a great start. But he was closed off by van Gisbergen.
A bump from Mostert gave him a critical edge.
And bang, you're going straight.
Staying up front meant they missed the chaos.
Monstrous trouble here. That is an extraordinary incident.
The ecstasy of James Golding's top 10 shootout debut quickly became a nightmare.
Launches across the top of the kerb, lucky not to roll it. That was a shocker.
My mistake, human error. Got too high on the kerb. Really disappointed and sorry for all the other teams and drivers that were involved.
As rescuers battled fires, the infamous beach chicane was again in a harsh light.
Just so disappointing, and that's why we, as drivers, lobby so hard to try and get rid of tyre bundles.
The damages bill will likely hit 7 figures, but van Gisbergen's car came home intact again. On resumption, he put a move on Davison and sped away, leaving the rest to fight over the scraps. His 21st win this season sparked after the early tussle with Davison.
I was pretty angry after the start, how they let him cut the chicane, so I was pretty fired up.
Red Bull wrap up the team's title. It's been a season that van Gisbergen and his new boss, Jamie Wincup, may never better. Pat Welch, 7 News.
Southeast Melbourne has kept in touch with the NBL's top 2 after leading by as much as 16 against Adelaide. It came right down to the wire, only to be sealed in overtime.
Kel, now it's going to be hard for Adelaide.
103-98, the final score. Melbourne City is closing in on claiming the top spot of the A-League ladder. A handball helped Jamie McLaren find the back of the net against Wellington. Their second goal, a little more conventional.
And he's found Marco Tilio, who makes it 2. Super finish.
Approaching full-time, City lead 2-0. Kevin De Bruyne has fired Manchester City back to the top of the Premier League, sealing a 1-0 win at Leicester City, while Newcastle demolished Aston Villa 4-0.
Wow! That is just astonishing! For Miguel Almiron!
Liverpool's miserable season continues. The Reds are 13 points off the pace after being beaten 2-1 by Leeds. I love how they celebrate in the EPL, but I must admit, while I'm all excited about finding out who the favourite for the cup is, I need to know whether I need to bring a jacket because this weather is scaring me, to be honest.
Is a puffer jacket okay for
fashions? I think it needs to be allowed.
We'll change the rules for that. Abby, thank you. Estelle Greepink's next with a forecast. Estelle, the warm, dry weather we saw today, it's not hanging around.
Well, Blake, a cool change is on the way. I'll tell you when next.
If there was an Olympic Games for entertainment, this is it.
Brand new Guinness World Records title.
But there's one act that breaks all the rules that all Australia will be talking about.
This is the best day of my life.
We have found the winner of Australia's Got Talent!
AGT, next on 7 and 7 Plus.
Protect yourself from BS with this from Sportsbet.
For races 1 to 4 at Flemington and Randwick, use your bet returns, and if you finish second or third, get up to $50 back in bonus bets with Sportsbet.
Sure, we could show the Kona N's 206 kilowatts of power racing down an abandoned airstrip, or doing laps at the Nürburgring. But here it is, leaving work at 17 kilometres an hour. It's not just fast, it's fun.
Introducing Ryobi's 36-volt HP battery mower. High-performance technology delivers all the power you'd ever need without the petrol emissions or the hassles. So, looks like petrol power is extinct. Ryobi 36-volt garden kits from $429, available at Bunnings Warehouse. Ryobi.
Chromebooks are a new way to laptop, starting with the Everything button, so you can find anything the moment you need it, from files and apps, even answers online, instantly. And Chromebooks are secure with virus protection that's built in. So no more of this, and a lot more peace of mind. So peaceful. So if you're ready to upgrade to fast, easy, and secure, don't just switch to a new laptop. Switch to a new way to laptop. Switch to Chromebook.
Green means
spring's here.
Salads, skewers, great time of the year. Healthiest own brands, times three. Delicious, nutritious, tasty. Green up packaging 2023. Better for the planet. And me! Green value, prices dropped. Now for spring, favourites chopped. Helping you get your woolies worth. That's today's fresh food, people.
Protect yourself from BS with this from Sportsbet.
For races 1 to 4 at Flemington and Randwick, use your bet returns, and if you finish second or third, get up to $50 back in bonus bets with Sportsbet.
Sure, we could show the Kona N's 206 kilowatts of power racing down an abandoned airstrip, or doing laps at the Nürburgring. But here it is, leaving work at 17 kilometres an hour. It's not just fast, it's fun.
Australia's big COVID con. The crime infecting every state. The multi-million dollar welfare fraud that cost taxpayers a fortune. Zero checks. Even blank applications given thousands. Now, finally, police swoop on 7 News Monday.
Hello again. We've had a lovely day to round out the weekend, staying dry under sunny skies. But this week brings the possibility of showers and storms. This is what it looked like in Leongatha today, where it reached a top of 20. In the city, it reached 21 after a low of 8. Across the state, temperatures were mostly in the low 20s. Horsham got to 19. This is what our suburbs are looking like right now. We're expecting strong winds to sweep through throughout tonight. The Bureau has issued a damaging winds warning for these areas, including Melbourne. Locations that may be affected include Bacchus Marsh, Ballarat and Maryborough. Around the nation tomorrow, Sydney's set for gusty winds and thunderstorms, but a top of 28. Brisbane's looking summery, a top of 31. Adelaide is expecting rainfall and a top of 16, while Perth is mild and settled, a top of 20. In our state, we could see widespread showers and possible thunderstorms in the south and east. Showers will be hit and miss in the northwest, but apart from that, it'll be a mostly cloudy day. Closer in, we have a high chance of showers over our suburbs and a possible thunderstorm over the northeast. The city could receive up to 10 millimetres of rain as we head for a top of 20 degrees. To the seven-day outlook, and Tuesday is looking like our wettest day of the week. The city could cop up to 15 millimetres of rain, and we could also see a thunderstorm and some small hail in the evening. On Wednesday, we also have a chance of showers and hail, but we should dry out later on. There's also the chance of a shower or two in store for Thursday, and from there, the temperature slowly starts to rise. By Friday, we'll be sitting on 17 degrees before a warm and dry weekend, 20 degrees on Saturday and 21 degrees on Sunday. But before we get there, prepare for some showers and the chance of a thunderstorm. From a low of 16, we're headed for a partly cloudy top of 20. So, Blake, I hope you made the most of today's warm and dry weather.
It's looking a little bleak. Estelle, thank you for that. That is 7 News. Thanks for making us part of your Sunday. From now, from the Melbourne News team, good night.